Welcome, everyone. Good evening. My name is Lee Greenhaw, and I'm the president of the Interfaith Partnership, Faith Beyond Walls, which is a volunteer organization to promote interfaith understanding. Tonight, I'm very glad to be bringing this program to you along with our good friends at the Michael and Barbara Newmark Institute for Human Relations at the Jewish Community Relations Council. This program is brought to you tonight to commemorate the 10th anniversary of those terrible terrorist attacks. Please take a moment to read in the back page of your bulletin a list, an amazing list, of generous St. Louis organizations, artistic and religious and civic, who together have made this night possible. We're also very honored to have with us tonight County Executive Dooley and many government and civic leaders. Welcome. Your presence here tonight to remember those tragic events a decade ago demonstrates our solidarity. Despite our differences in faith and despite our different perspectives, we come not only to remember tonight, but to broaden our reflections on that event, to deepen our experience of sorrow and regret, and to become a more unified community in our hope for peace. Would you join me as we gather in a moment of prayer? O God, be with us here this hour. Bind us here in St. Louis, together with those who mourn in New York City, Washington, D.C., and Pennsylvania. Join us to those victims of terror throughout the world, in Kabul, Madrid, Mumbai, wherever your children suffer terror and distress. unite us. Unite us in hope. Hope for that day when hatred and violence will cease. Amen. I'd like you to listen with me now to the message brought by an ordained Episcopal priest who is familiar to us all, and who also bears the titles of United Nations Ambassador, Missouri Attorney General, and U.S. Senator, Senator John Danforth.
Ten years ago today, our immediate response to the news was disbelief. Such a thing had never happened to us before, so it couldn't be happening now. It must have been an accident. Then a plane hit the second tower, and disbelief turned to shock. Then the Pentagon and a crash in Pennsylvania, and shock became fear. Government grounded all planes. If we worked in tall buildings, we went home. We gathered around TV sets. Then fear became anger, then rage. We swore revenge. Those who did this would hear from us. We would make them pay. Our anger has never left us, but something else soon appeared. It was a renewed patriotic spirit. There were small signs. We put flag pins in our lapels. We added, "God bless America," to take me out to the ball game. But far more important than appearances, we pulled ourselves together as a nation, setting aside our differences. All of us were under attack, so all of us became New Yorkers. We began to feel in our hearts what we have said by rote in our pledge. We knew that we were indeed one nation, indivisible. Terrorists tried to hurt us. They only strengthened our common bond. From our earliest days, the great challenge of America has been to create this common bond and hold together a diverse people. We are many, but we are one. E pluribus unum. It's our national purpose. For people who take religion seriously, people of faith, it's our religious calling. The literal meaning of religion is that which binds us together. 10 years ago, evil people confronted us with a fundamental choice. What drives us as a nation? Is it fear, anger, rage? Or is it what has been our purpose since our founding, the coming together as one people in the bond of peace? It's good to think of these things as we recall how we felt 10 years ago. There is still plenty of fear to drive us, if that's the way we want to go, and plenty of rage. Turn on the TV or radio for that, and plenty of division, the current state of our politics. Then there's a nobler cause, our purpose since our founding, when we knew that fear and anger would not suffice. It's the spirit of patriotism, the commitment that, with all our differences, we are all Americans, that we are all in this together, that we are one nation under God, indivisible.
simple. 'Tis the gift to be free. 'Tis a gift to come down where we ought to be. And when we find ourselves in the place just right, 'twill be in the valley of love and delight. When true simplicity is gained, to bow and to bend we shan't be ashamed. To turn will be our delight, till by turning, turning we come round right. Simple, 'tis the gift to be free, 'tis the gift to come down where we ought to be. And when we find ourselves in the place just right, 'twill be in the valley of love and delight.
Ladies and gentlemen, soprano Christine Brewer, accompanied by Peter Martin. Music this evening includes pieces from the Christian, Hindu, Jewish, and Muslim faith traditions. Each is a distinctive form of prayer, including the expression of gratitude and hope and the offering of praise. Even in languages that are not familiar to us, it is possible to understand that these prayers call upon God for guidance and strength in the face of evil, praises of God as a comfort and refuge for the dead, and thanksgiving for God's blessings, especially the blessings of peace. Next, we will hear two Islamic pieces. First, Mr. Orhan Bukakikaya of Turkey will recite a surah, a short chapter from the Quran in Arabic, and it speaks against hatred and of God as a refuge against evil. The second Muslim piece is a prayer, or dua, in the form of a contemplative poem. Often recited by children, it is known as a child's supplication. It will be performed by women from the Islamic Foundation of Greater St. Louis.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ولا تستوي الحسنة ولا السيئة ادفع بالتي هي أحسن فإذا الذي بينك وبينه عداوة كأنه ولي حميم وما يلقاها إلا الذين صبروا وما يلقاها إلا إِنَّهُ هُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ صَدَقَ اللَّهُ الْعَظِيمُ.
लपे आती है दुआ बन के तमन्ना मेरी
जिंदगी शम्मा की सूरत हो खुदाया मेरी
जिंदगी शम्मा की सूरत हो खुदाया मेरी लपे आती है दुआ बन के तमन्ना मेरी
दूर दुनिया का मेरे दम से अंधेरा हो जाए
दूर दुनिया का मेरे दम से अंधेरा हो जाए
हर जगह मेरे चमकने से उजाला हो जाए
हर जगह मेरे चमकने से उजाला हो जाए लपे आती है दुआ बन के तमन्ना मेरी
ओ मेरे दम से यूं ही मेरे वतन
हो मेरे दम से यूं ही मेरे वतन की जीनत
जिस तरह फूल से होती है चमन की जीनत
जिस तरह फूल से होती है चमन की जीनत
जिंदगी हो मेरी परवाने की सूरत यारब
जिंदगी हो मेरी परवाने की सूरत यारब
इल्म की शम्मा से हो मुझको मोहब्बत यारब
इल्म की शम्मा से हो मुझको मोहब्बत यारब
हो मेरा काम गरीबों की हिमायत करना
हो मेरा काम गरीबों की हिमायत करना
दर्दमंदों से ज़ईफों से मोहब्बत करना
दर्दमंदों से ज़ईफों
just heard the choir of Christ Church Cathedral, the Episcopal Cathedral in downtown St. Louis, led by Canon Precentor William Partridge. They sang Souls of the Righteous in the Hand of God from the Book of Wisdom, which was written over 2,000 years ago with music by T. Tertius Noble. And now, Anantur Ama Balachandran from the Hindu Temple of St. Louis will recite a prayer for universal peace.
Dvipate, chatushpate, cha shantin karo mi shantir me astu shanti hi om hari ki Shalom tofa vracha ein vacheset verachamim aleinu v'al kol ha'olam ha'olam amecha sim shalom tofa vracha Ein vacheset verachamim aleinu v'al kol ha'olam ha'olam amecha barchenu Kiechor, kibi or panecho, natatalano, Adonai Eloheinu, Torat Hayim, Ve'avat Chesed, Utsiracha, Uveracha, Virachamim, Bienecha livarech et amecha olam bechol eit uvechol shah bishlomecha sim shalom tofa uvracha Ein vacheset v'rachamim aleinu v'al kol ha'olam ha'olam amecha baruch atah
Good evening. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Timothy O'Leary, General Director of Opera Theater of St. Louis. We just heard cantor Ronald Eicher, accompanied by David Cohen, singing Mr. Cohen's setting of Sim Shalom, which praises God for the blessing of peace. Now, we'll hear from the St. Louis Chamber Chorus, led by Artistic Director Philip Barnes. They will sing the words of a poem by Walt Whitman. The music is by Granville Bantock. I'll read you just a bit of this beautiful text. It begins with an expression of anxiety about looking to a world beyond this one. Darest thou now, O soul, walk out with me toward the unknown region, where neither ground is for the feet, nor any path to follow, no map there, nor guide, nor voice sounding, nor touch of human hand, no face with blooming flesh. The poem, though, ends joyfully, with the hope that we will greet this moment with peace and readiness. The last lines include this: then we burst forth, we float in time and space, O soul, prepared for them, equal, equipped at last. Ladies and gentlemen, it's a pleasure to introduce again Christine Brewer, accompanied by Peter Martin. Christine will sing a song that you'll recognize, and she'll be joined by members of the St. Louis Symphony in unison chorus. We'll never quite know who created this American spiritual or where it first was sung. It's said to be inspired by the book of Job, which tells us, "In his hands is the life of every living thing and the breath of all mankind." We hear such hopefulness in this song, a hope that spans centuries, that spans peoples, and that carries special meaning for us today.
He's got the whole world in his hand. He's got the
Please join me in a moment of silent memorial. For everything, there is a season and a time for every purpose. So we have been taught.
This day we remember a time of national and human tragedy. This day we gather for a time of healing with a prayer for salam, shanti, shalom, peace, and shalem, wholeness. We achieve peace when we come together as we have this day in a spirit of wholeness. Sacred words and inspirational teachings carried on the wings of music have borne us along toward the illuminating, warming, and comforting light of God. With melodies and supplications, with praise and gratitude, pleadings and hope, we have come together this day, supporting one another, honoring those who died on this same day a decade ago. May this day, a day of memorial, be the day that we stand in the divine light, not as many, but as one. May this day be the beginning of a new season, a new time, when we stand with arms around one another and wish each other through the sweetest music of all. The words, Salam Aleichem, Shalom Aleichem, Shanti, peace to you. Amen. Thank you all for attending this beautiful memorial, and thank you so much to the artists and performers and all who participated in this memorial through music. This would not have been possible without the tireless and talented leadership of Batya Abramson Goldstein and Tim O'Leary. Please join our talented performers in the singing of God Bless America.